Hello everyone, this is Crota giving you a shoutcast between any pro prime world elite versus Todd here in the Zelnaga Caverns. It is not actually Wolf versus Todd, any pro borrowing Wolf's account. According to the website, we have Todd spawning on the south side of the map as the blue Protoss player. Meanwhile, on the north side of the map, we have any pro spawning as the red. One of those instances where my little thing on the side will definitely help us figure out who is who. This is not Wolf, this is AnyPro, and he is playing against Todd. Like in any mirror match, I want to keep track of the production tab and to see where they start to differ. Now, I know a lot of you guys out there don't like mirror matches, and I don't understand why. Mirror matches take place one in every three games, so if you guys don't watch mirror matches, you're missing out essentially on 33% of the games out there. So hopefully this mirror match will be exciting. It may just boil down to Foregate, but then Foregate is all about execution and who is able to use more out of what they've got. So we'll see what's going to be happening here. We already have Todd now coming in from the south in order to do some scouting. He scouted after the pylon as opposed to Wolf scouting after the gateway. And it does look like that Todd did not look to check if there was any proxy gates over here. So there are currently, he could have gotten proxy gate, but instead is quickly going to come in, see that there is the gateway here, the pylon here, and now just continue along his merry way. Todd now coming in to try to steal some of those minerals, unable to do so as another Peppy the Probe coming in and started to deal some damage. Instead, the probe just looking to start charging itself off of one pylon. The probe now looking to grab some of those minerals, able to steal some, and now will be able to return home 5 minerals in its, I guess, electronic mouth. We can see that we should be getting the Cybernetics Core in just a moment from Todd. Wait for the building. There it is. There is that Cybernetics Core. And we also should be getting, and the second pylon is already down. We are getting gas, and we may see a Zealot in just a moment from both of these sides. A Zealot now coming in from AnyPro, and there it is, a Zealot coming in from Todd. But Todd, just a split second slower so far throughout this matchup. So this pretty much is neck and neck in terms of the mirror match. AnyPro is slightly ahead in terms of pro production and Zealot count. And I believe his Cybernetics Core will come in. Oh, the Cybernetics Core coming at essentially the same time. And now both sides also getting that Warp Gate research. Warp Gate research is being chrono boosted. A Stalker is now being warped into play as well. It doesn't look like we're going to get a chrono boost onto the Stalker, as both sides have now stopped. Both sides have not stopped pro production, and now Todd also going for a second assimilator, so it is going to be different build. We'll see what these players are trying to go for. Todd, if he is going for more gateway building, will be able to get more sentries and stalkers just because he does have that additional assimilator. Todd currently is not training any additional probes right now, either is AnyPro, so it may be a 3 gate from both sides. No, it looks like it is going to be your standard 4 gate from AnyPro, and now a 4 gate coming in from Todd. So both sides opting to go for a 4 gate and now slowing down their production. Both sides sitting, we have Todd sitting on 21 probes versus 20. Now this maneuver by Todd to warp in this additional assimilator may be more of a head fake. He did warp it in, but he has not mined any gas off of it so far. So perhaps AnyPro will try to move out and try to perhaps get some damage, not knowing that Todd is going for the same exact thing as well. He is training up some additional probes. He may be able to get some more gas as well. And as long as he has sentries to block, he will be just fine. One probe, walking up that ramp, quickly getting destroyed. And now a Stalker on that high ground, gonna start shooting at that pylon. That pylon will take some damage as we are now getting another Stalker into play. No real way to see up onto that high ground yet. And a Zealot trying to run up, and that's not gonna work. Oh, actually, no Wolf. Oh, there's that force field. All those units are now gonna be stuck on the wrong side. They are gonna be able to see up that ramp though, as there are two sentries on the ramp. So Todd perhaps going to get another force field there, blocking any of those. Only the Stalker is able to deal any damage, and the pure range damage of Todd really winning out on this battle so far. More Zealots are getting destroyed, And now we may get another force field. Oh no, one sentry does get taken down. More units need to get force field back. If he's not careful, the sentry does not have enough energy just quite yet. So Stalker again, Stalker Zealots are now warping in. And now, will it be enough? There are the Stalkers here, and there are some lower hit point units. As those Stalkers now trying to walk up that ramp, there is that Sentry of Todd. Doesn't have enough energy just quite yet. Just a lot of Stalkers continuing to warp in on both sides as well. Is he going to be able to split up that army is going to be the key question. That one pylon now trying, oh, getting the force field there and now trapping some of those units on that high ground. Zealots now going to get taken down, but this pylon will get taken down as well. So one pylon down, coming in from Todd. The Todd does have a lot of room to maneuver as those Stalkers are trying to walk down that ramp. He has to be really careful. He does have two sentries though, and those two sentries are going to be able to get that force field. And now AnyPro being very careful to warp in an additional sentry as well to be able to block that ramp if Todd tries to walk down. We have 25 probes from Todd versus 20 probes from AnyPro as the sentries, if they try to move down, or the zealots try to move down, this is going to be very bad. If there's a force field there, there you go. And now you can see that Todd is stuck on the wrong side of the tracks. And now you can see Stalkers trying to engage. Oh, down goes one of those units. And now the Stalkers are being very carefully microed. And even though there is just enough room, both sides are now trying to walk down that ramp. It looks like Stalkers are going to get taken down. And now Todd doing a good job of microing those Stalkers and will be able to take them down one at a time. So this head fake of getting that earlier assimilator made AnyPro feel that he could push in very easily, and with that, well, ended up losing a lot more and biting off much more than he can chew. We can also see, oh, I thought I saw a Twilight Council. Yeah, Twilight Council is now in play. We may get Blink in just a moment as another pylon gonna get taken down. So Wolf now down two pylons. Looking at the losses, not Wolf, AnyPro now down two pylons. Looking at the losses in resources, 2575 versus 1750 as a Stalker now walks up this ramp. AnyPro does have one sentry and three zealots there. He is going to be getting immortals. Immortals very, very critical in trying to stop Stalkers. So I do like that play. AnyPro deciding to chrono boost out, or he was chrono boosting, I believe, an immortal. And as soon as that immortal comes out, a lot more damage could be dealt. A robotics bay now coming online as well. So that with that robotics bay, Colossus most likely coming in. We are getting that blink. Sentries and probes are still being trained up further and further. Now 29 probes compared to 26. Both sides, no, it looks like AnyPro has decided to slow down his probe production even further after getting an additional 6 probes, 3 on gas, 3 on minerals, in order to keep up with the economic game. But the longer this game goes, the better it will be for Todd, as Todd is going to get stronger and stronger as well, especially with the establishment of his natural expansion. So I like the head fake maneuver. I don't know if that was on purpose or on accident, but by Todd warping in that assimilator, only a 75 mineral investment, it made AnyPro feel that he could walk down that ramp and then try to push out with his four gate, and then realize that he was battling up against another four gate as well, which is very, very difficult. Stalkers, oh, trying to walk up that ramp, quickly getting blocked there. As soon as that Colossus comes out, I believe Todd will be forced to go into full retreat mode, as those Stalkers are not going to be able to do all that much. There is some decent number of Stalkers here, 9 Stalkers, 10 Stalkers now, and they do have Blink. So that Blink will be very critical as well. Are the Stalkers going to try to walk up that ramp now, getting some damage, and oh, blinking away as soon as it saw that Colossus. And those Stalkers are now trying to walk all the way home. They're going to have plenty of time. Level 1 weapons upgrade now being researched. Those Stalkers, as long as they're able to blink in and get within range on that Colossus, should be able to maximize that damage very, very quickly. There are a decent number of Zealots, though. So those Zealots are going to be swarming around that Colossus. And as soon as it swarms around that Colossus, the Stalkers are going to be taking damage from both Colossus and Zealots. And that's going to be very difficult to deal with, even when you add in that Immortal. Immortal's very powerful, very effective against Stalkers, dealing 50 damage in attack. The Stalkers of Todd now attempting to clear out this location here, as Todd realizes there is an incoming attack force. Todd not really having to worry about losing his Stalker. His Stalker does have Blink and would be able to get away very, very quickly. This set of destructible rocks will get destroyed very easily. And now we are also getting Zealot Charge, but we are not getting the Chrono Boosted out yet, so these Zealots are not going to have that upgraded movement speed just quite yet. We do have the Colossus and one Photon Cannon offering some additional support, as well as there are Stalkers down over here. The Stalkers are going to be able to engage and try to flank this position. The Sentries do not have enough, and that Guardian Shield really not that effective against Stalkers, or even against Colossus. I guess it is decently effective, as those Zealots are now in full retreat. Another Guardian Shield now being used. Both sides are going to battle it out. Stalkers can just easily blink in and now swarm around their target. Down goes the Colossus, and now that any pro doesn't have that Colossus, and the Zealots are caught on the wrong side, that's going to be even more difficult. A lot of that time the Zealots were not engaging, and as soon as those Zealots were not engaging, that was not going to be enough. And there's the GG from AnyPro. AnyPro losing this game to Todd here in the Zelnaga Caverns. Just a really well-played, well-executed game from Todd. Todd having his expansion, and AnyPro realizing that as soon as those Stalkers blinked and swarmed, and those Zealots were unable to engage in that battle, they were just stuck behind his own Stalkers, unable to melee attack. That really hurt him. I do think that if Todd had Chrono Boosted out his charge, perhaps 2 to 3 charges of Chrono Boost, he would have had Zealot Charge at the start of the battle, if not during the middle of it, and these Zealots would have been able to finish off the Stalkers even more quickly. You can see there's a lot of energy across both of the Nexuses, and I wish that was something that Todd did, but Todd still played an excellent game. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. I hope you guys enjoyed this 1v1 replay between AnyPro, Prime, World Elite, and Millennium Todd here in the Zelnaga Caverns.